Hey there, folks. Hope you are doing well. We've got a trade to talk about for the Vancouver Canucks. Ole Yule Levy getting moved to the Florida Panthers. We are here in a hotel room on vacation, but we got some breaking news that we got to talk about. So Thomas Drouin's coming through with the details. It's Ole Yule Levy going to Florida. In return, the Canucks get Juho Lamiko. Excellent name. Finnish player, 25 years old, sort of a depth guy, center, left winger, 6'3", 200 pounds or so. And Noah Juulsen out of Surrey, British Columbia, hometown kid, born in April 1997, 24 years old, 6'2", 201. So a couple of people who were also drafted a year and 2 years before Juho Levy. Juulsen has a bit of that first round pedigree as well, but let's talk about Ole Juho Levy to start, because that is sort of the big thing, is the Canucks giving up on the Ole Juho Levy experiment. And it kind of made sense. As training camp progressed, it was pretty clear that Rathbone was ahead of Juho Levy. Brad Hunt was probably also ahead of Juho Levy. So basically where Ole Juho Levy was, is he was either going to be in the press box or he would have to be sent down to Abbotsford. And sending him down to Abbotsford means he has to go through waivers. He would almost assuredly get claimed on waivers. Lots of teams, especially lower in the standings teams, could use a guy like Ole Juho Levy in maybe the 5-6 slot. But the Canucks have a ton of sort of sixth defenseman caliber players. So these teams like, you know, a Buffalo or San Jose or a team at the bottom of the standings would say, hey, let's take a shot on Juho Levy. We might be able to develop him into something. While the Canucks trying to make the playoffs now, they need good players. And Ole Juho Levy just wasn't going to cut it. Juho Levy last year played 23 games for the Canucks, had 3 points. He was a minus one. He was okay, but it was pretty clear that he didn't have the foot speed to keep up. The bag skate looked like it didn't do good graces with the coach. We had that one quote from Travis Green a bit over a week ago saying, yeah, Ole Juho Levy didn't do himself any favors during training camp. So it was sort of a matter of time whether he was going to get waived or traded. The waiver deadline passed this morning. We saw guys like DiGiuseppe, Bowie, Hamonic going on waivers for the Canucks, which we won't go too much into there. We'll talk more about that on Canucks After Dark on Tuesday night at 10 o'clock. Link in the description for that. It was sort of the end of the road for Ole Juho Levy as a Canuck. He's going to get another shot in the Florida Panthers organization to try to land a spot on their NHL squad. And in return, the Canucks get two decent depth pieces in return. No draft picks. Lots of people were saying, oh, they're just going to get a fifth back. Does it really matter anyways? Which it wouldn't really. But they get two players in Noah Juulsen and Juho Lamiko. Let's talk about Noah Juulsen first. Like I said, 24 years old, 200 pounds, 6'2". He is a right shot defenseman. Now, the Canucks already have a lot of right shot defensemen, but I believe he is already in the AHL system. I don't think he has to go through waivers anymore. So he would go in as basically a shoe-in to be on the Abbotsford Canucks as a pretty good piece for the Abbotsford Canucks. And he's a guy that you can call up and you can have him play games in your NHL lineup as well. He played a few years in the Montreal system. He was drafted by Montreal in the first round of 2015, 26th overall pick. He's played about 50 NHL games, it looks like, so far. Nothing too flashy offensively. Last year, just played 4 NHL games, 5 AHL games, but should just be a good depth piece in case of injury. Can get called up, sent down freely, not having to deal with waivers. So a decent player to pick up there. And if we talk about Juho Lamiko, 25-year-old center slash left winger. He's big, 6'3", 200 pounds. He's a left shot from Finland. And if we look at some of his stats here, he played 44 games for Florida last year. So he was in their lineup, a staple in their lineup. Only 4 goals, 1 assist for 5 points. So he looks like he'll be basically sort of a fourth line player. I'm not sure if he factored in on their penalty kill at all. And that would be something that would be interesting to note, because right now, with the injuries the Canucks have to Tyler Motte, Brandon Sutter, and the like, it's the penalty kill is looking a little bit iffy. You're going to have guys like maybe Highmore have to step into a role there. We've seen JT Miller in the past. But if Juho Lamiko can be a decent penalty killer, take some minutes away from those top guys, that could also be a good piece as well. Anyways, I think that's all I've got for this one. Leave your thoughts on the trade down below, and I will see you in the next one.